Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. This is Amanullah. You're watching my YouTube channel, Dr. Aman's video. Dear viewer, today we will discuss the interpretations of the different serological marker used for the diagnosis and differentiation of different phases of the hepatitis B virus infection. As we know that we used different serological marker for the diagnosis of the hepatitis B virus and for the differentiation of the different phases of the clinical course of the hepatitis B virus, like chronic and acute. And we also used the different serological marker to decide that the person is susceptible for the infection of hepatitis B virus or the person is immunized against the infection of hepatitis B virus. But first of all, I would like to tell you about the locations of the different antigens in the structure of the hepatitis B virus. This is the rough diagram of the hepatitis B virus. As we know that hepatitis B virus is an enveloped DNA containing virus. So this black lines show the envelope of the virus, which is the outer covering. Then second to the envelope, the green line show the protein coat or capsid of the virus. Finally, these blue lines indicate the nucleic acid, which is DNA in the case of hepatitis B virus. So coming to the most important antigen, hepatitis B surface antigen is the part of the envelope of the hepatitis B virus, which is present at the outermost surrounding of the structure of the hepatitis B virus. As we know that our immune system produces antibodies against the foreign antigen. So in this case, the antibodies produced against the hepatitis B surface antigens are known as anti-HBs. The second important antigen is the hepatitis B core antigen. Hepatitis B core antigen is the integral part of the protein coat of the hepatitis B virus, and two types of antibodies are produced against this antigen. One is anti-HBs of IgM class. Second is the anti-HBs of total class. The word total indicate actually IgG and IgM both antibodies. Though predominantly the anti-HBs total include IgM and IgG antibodies, but a low level of IgMs are also produced. Therefore, they are known as total anti-HBs, while this purely known as IgM anti-HBs. Finally, the third antigen, which is known as HBe antigen. HBe antigen is not the part of the structure of the hepatitis B virus, but they are produced during the replication of the virus inside the host cell, and they are known as immune modulating protein because these protein HBe antigens are secreted in the cell and outer environment of the cell, and they try to modulate the immune system of the host environment of the host body in order to make a conducive environment for the survival of hepatitis B virus. Our immune system also produced antibodies against hepatitis B and hepatitis B E antigen, which are known as anti-HBe. So these are the serological markers which are used for the diagnosis interpretations of the hepatitis B virus infection. Finally, the hepatitis B virus DNA is also a marker which is used for the diagnosis of the hepatitis B virus. DNA is a direct and accurate marker used for the diagnosis of HBV infection, and the level of the HBV DNA is actually needed for deciding the antiviral treatment for HBV, and the level of the DNA present in the serum of the patient is also used as a tool for the prognosis or for to monitor the effect of the treatment of the antiviral therapy. Now, how we will interpret the presence or absence of these markers for the deciding or for the decisions of the different phases or diagnosis of HBV virus infection. So before starting this table, I would like to tell you that HBs antigen, hepatitis B surface antigen, is the hallmark of hepatitis B virus. It means that the presence of HBs antigen always indicate the presence of virus inside the body of the person. So it means that whenever HBs antigen is present, it means that the person is infected. Either it is acute, chronic, or any other case, it will be decided after the combination of other serological marker, as we will discuss later in this lecture. Same, the antibodies produced against HBs antigens. So the most important thing to note is that anti-HBs is only produced in acute infection of hepatitis B virus. They will not produce, or they are not produced in the chronic infection of hepatitis B virus. Why it is the case? There are certain reasons, but today we are concerned only about the interpretation of these serological markers. So come to the point again that anti-HBs are only produced in acute infection. So therefore, the presence of anti-HBs always indicate either the recovered or resolved acute infection, or it show the vaccination. So we will discuss in this chapter. Second, HB core antigen, hepatitis B core antigen. Hepatitis B core antigen is never secreted into the blood of the patient. It remains inside the nucleus of the host cell where the virus is replicating. Therefore, hepatitis B core antigen is not tested for the interpretation or for the clinical interpretation. Rather, we detect or we measure the two types of antibody produced against hepatitis B core antigen. The first antibody, anti-HB core of IgM or IgM anti-HB core, it means that the antibody which are IgM in nature and produced against the hepatitis B core antigen. So these IgM types of antibody always produced in the first phase of the hepatitis or acute phase of the hepatitis, and after 6 months the presence of IgM decline and finally it disappear from the serum or blood of the patient. So therefore, IgM anti-HBC always indicate the recent infection or acute infection, while total anti-HBC, as I told you, that predominantly they are IgG in nature. This is the most constant marker of hepatitis B virus used in clinical interpretation, because total anti-HBC is produced in current infection, either acute or chronic, and it is also present after recovery. So therefore, it is the most constant marker which shows the presence or exposure of hepatitis B virus. HBe antigen and anti-HBe are not usually used for clinical interpretation, but HBe antigen usually indicate the higher replication or the higher amount of the hepatitis B DNA or the higher rate of the replication of the hepatitis B virus. Therefore, the presence of the HBe antigen indicate a greater risk of the transmission of hepatitis B virus to another persons after exposure, like through needle stick injury or from mother to fetus if a pregnant woman is suffering from hepatitis B virus, or any other physical contact which are the documented route for the transmission of hepatitis B virus. If hepatitis B E antigen is absent and antibodies against hepatitis B E antigens are present, this show that the viremia is very low and the rate of replication is very low. Therefore, the risk of transmission of hepatitis B virus after contact is very low. So the importance or the significance of hepatitis B E antigen and anti-HBe usually indicate the rate of transmission or the risk transmission. So now come to this table. that how can we interpret the presence and absence of different serological markers. So if a person is negative for hepatitis B surface antigen, negative for total anti-HBC, negative for this, it means that this patient is susceptible. It has been never exposed in any way to hepatitis B virus, so it is susceptible for the contraction of hepatitis B virus after contact with hepatitis B virus. Second case, if a person is negative for hepatitis B surface antigen but positive for total anti-HBC and negative for IgM anti-HBC and positive for anti-HBs. So this indicate that it is a past natural infection which has cleared and the immunity is achieved. As I told you, the anti-HBs antibodies are produced against this hepatitis B surface antigen. So these are protective antibodies. It means that they can provide protection to you against the HBV infection. So this antibodies is present, therefore immunity is achieved. And total anti-HBC is present, but IgM is absent, which show recent infection. HbS is absent, which show the presence of virus. It means that virus is not present and no acute antibodies are present. It means that this person was infected recently and it was suffer from acute hepatitis B infection, but the infection is now cleared and the person is immune due to the presence of anti-HBs antibody. And this constant marker show that this person has been exposed to the hepatitis B virus very recently. Next, HBs is negative but total HBC is positive, negative. Again, this is past infection, but the infection is clear, but immunity is not achieved because anti-HBs has waned away because it has been degraded after some times. So anti-HBs is not present. It means that the person is not immune for the subsequent infection, but it has been resolved from the previous acute infection. So past natural infection cleared, but anti-HBs is waned. So it means that immunity is not achieved as in this case. Third condition, person is negative for HBs, negative for total anti-HBC, negative for IgM anti-HBC and positive for anti-HBs. It means that this person is immunized or this person has achieved immunity due to vaccination. In simple word, you can say that this person has used vaccine or this person has vaccinated his or herself against the hepatitis B virus. Now, the other case, if anti-HBs is absent, hepatitis B surface antigen is absent, but total anti-HBC is present, IgM anti-HBC is, total anti-HBC is present, IgM anti-HBC is present, and anti-HBs is present. It means that recent infection recovered and immunity achieved. The presence of this antibody show that immunity is achieved. The presence of this antibody show the exposure, and the presence of IgM antigate, they indicate that the exposure is in very recent, but it has been resolved. Now, finally, the two important interpretation which is used for the presence of infection. If anti-HBs is present, total anti-HBC is present, IgM anti-HBC is present, and anti-HBs is absent. So HBs is present, it means that the person is infected, the virus is present. Total anti-HBC also indicate the exposure. So this IgM anti-HBC always used to differentiate the acute and chronic, because I have told you that IgM anti-HBC waned away after 6 months of the infection. So IgM is present, IgG is present or total is present, and HBs antigen is present. It means that it is acute infection which is in ongoing stage. Second case, HBs antigen is present, it means that the person is infected. So total anti-HBC is present. So it confirms that this person is exposed to the hepatitis B virus. But IgM is absent. It means that the exposure is not recent because the IgM has waned away, has disappeared from the blood of the person, and anti-HBs is also absent. This show this case is chronic infection, and the chronic infection is still ongoing. So these are the different interpretation. CDC also interpret this case that the presence of only total anti-HBC can also be interpreted beside this past natural infection, that it could be the case of low level chronic infection. So these are the interpretations of the combinations of different markers which is used for the diagnosis and differentiation of acute and chronic infection. These two rows are very important for the purpose of positive cases, or in the positive cases of hepatitis B virus infection. So this along with this show acute infection, this with absence of IgM anti-HBC show chronic infection. I hope you would find this video useful for yourself. If it is the case, then I would request you that please subscribe my YouTube channel, Dr. Aman's Video, and also try to hit bell icon in order to get notification for my upcoming video. Thank you so much for watching my YouTube channel. Fi Amanullah.